by working with square roots. We simplify them when they're not perfect squares. And we're going to learn another way to simplify them instead of using the calculator or approximating like we did in the last section. All right, so let's just show you, I'm going to show you two quick things to how to kind of work with radical symbols. So let's say they give you a problem that looks like this. One way to solve this is to multiply what they have on the inside. So 4 times 16 is 64. And what times what equals 64? 8 does. But let me show you what else you can do instead of, maybe you didn't know what 16 times 4 is. You can do something else instead. Take a look. I'm going to start with the same problem. Instead of multiplying, I'm going to break this apart. I have two perfect squares in here. I'm going to find the square root of 4 and the square root of 16. Well, the square root of 4 is 2, and the square root of 16 is 4, so 2 times 2. It's 8. So that's the kind of stuff we're going to be dealing with. Know that there are some rules when working with simplest form. There are 3 of them to be exact. The first rule, no factors can be perfect squares. No factors. So that's inside the radicand symbol. So let's say you get to the end of the problem and you get something that looks like this. That's a perfect square in that radical symbol, so you have to keep going. So you don't want to do this. Okay? Next rule. No fractions under the radical sign. So what does this mean? I'm going to leave a little space because I'm going to write something right here. Let's say we have the square root of 63. 63 is not a perfect square. So instead, I'm going to find some factors that have perfect squares in it. So let's start going through all the different factors that make 63. So let's start with 2. 2 does not second set has a perfect square, so I'm going to use that. So I'm going to break 63 up into 7 and 9. Why are we looking for perfect squares? Because we can break them down. We can take the square root of 9. The square root of 9 is 3. Okay, now I'm going to write it in a more complete way. When you have a number that's outside of the radical sign, that's always going to be pulled out in front. So my final answer is going to look like that. Okay, so the one thing I want to write in here, this is why I love this space, is you're going to look for factors that have perfect squares.
Multiplication.
Now it's your turn. Try the square root of 176 a squared. All right, so I'm going to list all the factors. It may have taken me a while to think of factors. 2 times 88, those aren't perfect squares. 3 does not go with. 4 times 44, still I don't have any perfect squares. The next factor would be 8 and 22. Unfortunately, no perfect squares. But if you would have kept working, 11 and 16 are perfect squares. So I'm going to break this down. 11 times the square root of 16 times the square root of a squared. The square root of 16 is 4. The square root of a squared is a. I'm going to keep 11 in the square root of the red symbol. So my final answer is 4a square root of 11. Whew. All right, that's just the product property of square roots. There is a quotient property. It kind of works in the same manner. This is the quotient property of square roots.
Now this is
push pause and try your best, see what you can do.